Hello, fighter fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1-100 Master Raid Shenlong Fighter. It's from TD Hongli. I bought this model at Gundam Central, and there's a good reason. I wasn't initially going to, until I realized it is not just the Shenlong Gundam, it is the Shenlong Gundam with the Liaoyo sword. It's like the version that's... there's a version of... I think it's the manga where there's different... variations, upgrades to the wing Gundams, with different stuff, like the Death Scythe has, like, these little, like, opening up thruster sort of things, and the Sandark has, like, this shell armor. Well, the Sandark has a big sword. I think it's called the Dragon Fang. Maybe not. Don't know. Dragon Fang sword. I don't know. So, it is a knockoff, and it's, actually really good, surprisingly. If I compare this back to, like, the... I think the first one they did was the Master Grade Hino Gundam. I did nothing to this model. I didn't have to glue anything. Well, there are some things I will have to do, but I didn't glue anything. I didn't have to modify anything. I just kind of snapped it together. Now, like I said, some parts are loose. The size of the head here, the horns, they fall off rather easily. This part here, where this is the opening cockpit, it's just hanging on because of the chest. The little yellow pieces on the arms like to pop off, and the side skirts, the pieces of them, like to come off the inner frame. Other than that, the rest of it's pretty good. It is cheaper plastic, it is more pliable. The V-fin here actually was bent when I first took it out of the package. I was able to straighten it, you can see the stress mark. But sometimes having more bendable plastic is a good thing, because if that was a Bandai kit and that happened, that might have snapped. So I'm just saying. Other than that, I don't want to go into too much detail. I've already done the Master Grade Bandai release, which I'll put a link to right here if you want to see everything, which this kit has. All the articulation is the same. It is solid for a knockoff. It does have detail. Not as crisp, of course. The colors, I think, are a little duller, like the blue and the red. It does have all the accessories. You got the shield, which... it's pretty good. It does peg into the arm. And it'll stay. You've also got the Dragon Fang, of course, which has the extra joints for the mouth. These pieces here, the white parts on the side, they like to pop off. Actually, it's this one here. This one's actually holding this one in place. And you've got the connector, which it will connect. It actually connects better than... to the arm than the parts on the actual Dragon Fang, so when I try to pull it off, those parts on the side usually pop off first. And of course you have the Beam Trident, which it's nicely detailed effect part. It is a little foggier than it should be, but it's okay. You can mount it on the back with a little extra connector. You just pull this one out, put the connector in to have it stored. Or you can hold it all right. It's okay. And you also have, because I should mention the stickers, the foil ones are crap. They actually, the eyes, let me see if I can show you this, the eyes, the black around the eyes actually didn't come off the actual sheet. So you got silver underneath there. Yeah, cameras were okay. And it does come with the other decals. You got the rub transfer and peel off, which, well, they look okay. Not sure how they apply. And, of course, the reason I bought this is for the, well, let's call it the Dragon Fang sword for now. I'm sure there's a, I don't know if that's the official name. Some people probably mention it. It's pretty big. It looks nice. It doesn't stay together 100%. It's, the main body is two halves. So, I'd have to paint this and glue this, because this should be red, and these parts I think should be yellow, and the blade's white, so there is some painting involved, and some gluing, but I like it, I really do. And it's pretty solid, it's not flimsy, just that the parts stay together. And now, another thing with the model, it does have the interchangeable hands, the open hand, the fist, the holding hand, and then the holding hand with the peg. Some of them stay in, and some of them won't. The one without the pegs don't stay in. And they would probably be better for this. Because you see there's no hole for the peg. Although it will still hold it. more or less. You just kind of have to fiddle around with it, like that. And so what's supposed to happen is, it's a plug, this little piece here that came with the sword, goes into the little gap on either side of the shield. So they're utilizing extra little spaces on the model for these for this add-on, which I'm assuming is a resin kit that they just took and made plastic. And so you plug that in, and then you get a wire cord. Stand up. You get a wire cord, which is bendable, but it doesn't stay. So you can see I've tried to plug it in, and it's kind of already starting to take the outer casing off. It'll plug in. It won't stay that well, so gluing is required. Or if you have another wire, which I probably do, I'll just use that. But I do like this sword. It is very nice. A little bit of paint, and it will look very good with my Bandai Shenlong, which is why I bought it. Speaking of the Bandai, here it is. And, yeah, they look really close. I think you can tell the reds and blues are not as vibrant on the knockoff as compared to the real one. Now, I did mention, or did I mention, I've done this a few times, but I had two reasons to get the knockoff, not just for the sword. I want to cannibalize this guy for the accessories. I want to take the dragon fang and the extra end, the trident part with the effect. And I have an extra Shenlong, which I got already assembled from someone else. I bought a whole bunch of kits from months ago. And I'm going to make an EW Ultron, because they apparently don't have one. They have Shenlong and then right to Nataku. But I want an Ultron, so I need both dragon fangs and a double-sided trident. Which I'll have now. Just have to paint it differently. And add wings, which I'll probably make with a plate. So yeah, I had reason to buy this. Now, I can't really recommend it on its own. I'd obviously get the Bandai one, but if you like the sword, and you want to give it to the Bandai, I'd say get it. If you maybe broke some parts in the process, or lost some parts when you're building your Shenlong, and you like that sword, but you can't quite justify it, well, that's a good reason. Cannibalize this guy to complete this guy. And you get a nice-ass sword, too. So, well, that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.